Walmart, and I remember being in Walmart, and the express line was not moving, and it has the purpose of moving. And because it's not moving, people are getting very upset. One lady lifts her hands in the air, she goes, "What kind of Walmart is this?" Expecting somebody to say, "It's the bad one, you chose poorly. You should go to a different Walmart." And there's a little man in front of me, a little bald-headed man. Now, I got nothing wrong with being bald, but he was getting so mad. His head was turning so many different colors. And it was all I could do not to touch his head and go, "Turn green. Turn blue." Here was the holdup. There's a little elderly man at the counter pulling everything out at quantum speeds. One tic-tac. He looked sad, despondent, like life had wore him out. And you know what? I had a principal come up to me the other day, and he shared with me a quote that he has in his office. He said, "Sometimes life gives you a pile." And I looked at him like, "Well, that's interesting." And he says, "When you got the right attitude, you look at that pile as fertilizer." I'm like, that's a good quote. Very successful principal with his staff. And this guy looked like life had given him a pile. And he unlocked my compassion immediately. And I looked at this old man, and I remember thinking, he looks so sad. And the lady behind the register, she works for a $1 billion company, but she does not let a $1 billion company determine or limit her attitude. Because what we send out comes back. When the farmer plants a seed, what is the farmer entitled to? The farmer is entitled to an expectation upon that seed for a harvest. And whatever you send out, it will come back. If you come to me and you say, "My life stinks," the first thing I might tell you is, are you making life stink for other people? Because if you are, it's probably coming back. And that's only half of it, because I know sometimes life is tough. But we have to think about that. What are we sending out? And this little lady looks at this old man and she says, "Sir, you having a good day?" And he snapped at her. He says, "Nope." I remember thinking, I don't think he's having a good life. And she didn't snap back. I thought it merited a snap back, like, yeah. And the old man begins walking away. His back is hunched over. He looks like he's ready to fall over. And the lady looks at the customers who've been waiting. She says, "Please wait." And she calls out to the old man, "Excuse me, sir." He turns, "Yes. I was wondering, have you had a hug today?" He looks at her and he says, "No." And I'm holding all my stuff in the back of the line thinking, this must be new at Walmart. We're giving out hugs. And she looks at the old man and I quote, she says, "I'm going to give you one of mine because they're good." She leaves the register and she walks up to this old man and she grabs him like a woman who had jumper cables. She starts squeezing, and as she's squeezing, her eyes are shut and she's just holding onto this guy, squeezing the Charmin out of him. And then the impact happened. His eyeballs looked like they were ready to explode out of his head. A smile appeared upon his wrinkled face, color went into his skin, his back straightened up. She made his day, he'd take it with him, and he now had something to give away. And what was the impact of the line? All of us are now smiling at each other. That lady who was very vocal, she's turning around, she goes, "What is going on?" Attitude creates an experience for you and for others, and she had a great attitude. And that little bald-headed man turns back to me, looks up at me, and he says, "Hey, big guy, think we're gonna get one of those hugs?" I looked down, I said, "I'll give you a hug." We didn't talk the rest of the way. It was very uncomfortable. Apparently, I created an uncomfortable moment. And when I stepped up to this woman, I always like to ask people why they do what they do that's great. What inspires them to be great? To let the greatness of their attitude shine, that it makes a difference and changes people's lives. And so I stepped up and she smiles at me. She goes, "You having a good day?" I smiled down, I'm like, "I am." And then I leaned in and I said something, and this is very ADD. You need to know this about people with ADD. We will say stuff and do stuff very impulsively and think about it later. give you a quick example. Little boy, 6 years old, is playing in a park, sees three blonde women who are professional wrestlers on a park bench. The little boy runs up and says, "Would you guys like to hear a blonde joke?" One of the ladies looked down and says, "You might want to think about telling that joke, boy." Little boy says, "Yeah, you're right. I don't want to have to explain it three different times." So, don't forget attitude number one. Some of you look like you want to hurt me. So I leaned in and I said something to this lady that was out there referencing the old man, and I remember it was out there. I'm like, "Bring it back." I looked at her and I leaned in and I said, "Let me ask you something. Does Walmart pay you extra to hug weird-looking men?" She stops, she smiles, she leans in, and she goes, "Why? Do you need one?"